Good morning again, friends. And we've been on transformation. And I believe God, like we said on Monday, our life must be a blessing, it must be useful. On Tuesday, we said all our ventures and our adventures, our effort, if we turn it to God, it will become a joy. Today, we're going to go a bit further. And we're going to emphasize on a decision that will change your life. Let us pray. Father, we thank you so much because you are our joy. And it doesn't matter what the statement and the position of people concerning us, you can make all things beautiful for us. This morning, Father, please speak to us again. And let every life speaking and listening to me glorify your name. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Remember our text, Genesis chapter 1 verse 2. The Bible says that at times a life can be good for nothing until the Spirit of God will come in. And what you do when the Spirit of God comes in is very important. Like today, we want to consider someone that did something about his own. In 1 Chronicles chapter 4, 1 Chronicles chapter 4, 9 and 10, the Bible talks about a man called Jabez. A lot of times we have talked about this Jabez, we have prayed about his prayers, and we didn't realize something. His situation was that he said Jabez was more honorable. Now, more honorable today, you can liken it to Jabez was a born-again Christian. But his foundation, his background, his mother termed him and labeled him, the orientation they gave him was sorrowful. The mother made him believe that he can be better than he is, that his life is just packaged to be sorrowful. And the mother named him Sorrow. Now, every time they talk to Jabez, they tell him, if Jabez said, I want to laugh, they say, no, you can't laugh. You are sorrow. If Jabez said, oh, I want to try my hands on this business, say, no, it will fail. That is the cage they put in Jabez, sorrowful. Everything about him, he wanted to get married, say, no, you can't get married. Oh, he wants to say, oh, no, you can't do it, it will fail. And there are many people have been telling you, it's not possible, it won't work, you will fail, don't try it. In our family, nobody has done it like that before. In our country, nobody, beloved brethren, there's always a first time. There's always a first person. There's always a first setter. And that is the plan of God for us. He said we'll be the head and not the tail. But Jabez, in verse 10, 1 Corinthians 4 and 10, the Bible says, Jabez prayed to God. Jabez bring the matter to God. Jabez submitted the matter to God. Jabez remembered that Jesus said, you are the light of the world. Let your light so shine. So there's no way that can align with sorrowful. And the Bible says, Jesus told us, be of good cheer, I have overcome. So how can I be of good cheer if they told me it's all about sorrow? I don't know what men have told you. I don't know how they have caged you. I don't know how they have lied to you. But beloved, the Bible says, when you know the truth, you'll be free. The truth is that, I'll read as I conclude. Hebrews 12 verse 1 and 2. This is the truth. We have all these great people around us as examples. You can choose. There's always somebody in your family that is not like every other person. There's always somebody in your neighborhood. There's somebody you can choose. But one main person to choose as we go. Their life tells us what faith means. Your family, your parents, your brothers and sisters, people before you, your bosses in the office, your clients, people that have influenced you. You have choice. Many of them are around. So we too should run. Now they are running their own. You too should take a decision to run your own. You should take a decision what you want to be in life and how you want to be. You should run. That race that is set before us, every man has his own race. And that's why you must run your own race. Don't follow others. And never quit, which is very important. If they tell you to fail, try it. But let me tell you a secret. Trying it is very key. Failure, if they told you you fail in the first place, then trying it will make it better. See, we should remove from our life anything that has said into your mind, anything that is in your life, your own personal character and attitude that does not glorify God, a sinful nature in you. So we should set them aside. So we must never stop looking to Jesus. Beloved brethren, I want to challenge you. Whatever area they have tapped that is not going to succeed in your life, I want you to take it to Jesus today. And I believe God, I will hear your testimony. I'll see you tomorrow. God bless you.